Change your
heart,
Lord, change our hearts. Actions are judged by their intention, and every man shall be judged accordingly. And whatever you keep inside of your heart.
إن الحمد لله ونحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، ومن يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, wherever you are around the globe at this present time, I greet you with the greetings of the believers. Assalam. Peace. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be upon you and the mercy and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I first and foremost ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless this time that we'll be spending together and to accept it as an hour that is solely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow it to be an hour in which we can grow together. An hour in which we can recharge our hearts from the trials and tribulations that have afflicted us from throughout the week. My beloved brothers and sisters, let us begin by asking ourselves a question. What have we done for Islam? What have we done to advance, to progress, to raise the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? La ilaha illallah. There is no God except for Allah. What have we done to raise this word throughout the earth? Whenever we think about personal sacrifices, we often think about a parent sacrificing for his children, giving him the best school, giving him the best education. Or we think about an athlete that has sacrificed his sweat and his efforts for his country to win that gold medal, to take that gold medal from the Olympics. But what about Allah? What about the Deen of Islam? What have we done for Islam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسُهُمْ وَأَمْوَالُهُمْ بِأَنَّ لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, indeed, Allah has purchased from the believers their lives and their wealth, and in exchange for that is the paradise. The life of the believer, my brothers and sisters, is a life like no one else on this earth, the true believer. It is a life like no one else on this earth. The true believer has sold his life and his wealth for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has sold his life and his wealth to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the price that he got for it is paradise. Jannah, the place that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, taught us that the smallest amount of paradise, a square centimeter of paradise, is greater than this whole world and everything that is inside it. Paradise, my brothers and sisters, is not something that we inherit from our mothers or fathers. It is not something that we inherit from our countries or our flags. It is not something that we inherit because our name was Ahmed or Fatima and it was written on our passport that we were Muslim. No. Paradise is something that can only be attained through sacrifice and through the good deeds that you place in this earth and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Quran, وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُمْ وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, and whatever you bring forth of good, it is for yourself and you will find it when you meet Allah. You will find it when you meet Allah. The sacrifices that you make in this world for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will find it when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those who sacrificed, the best example were the Sahaba, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Muhajirun and the Ansar, those who immigrated and those who helped the helpers, those who helped. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described them in the Quran as the real true believers. Not only the true believers, but the real true believers. And anyone who follows their way until the end of time falls into this category. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَهَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آوَوْا وَنَصْرُوا أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقًّا لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said about them, those who have believed and have immigrated and have fought in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who gave shelter and aided and gave victory to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's cause, they are the real true believers. For them is forgiveness and a noble provision. Those of you who are seeking forgiveness, then sacrifice your time for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those of you who are seeking provision, rizq, sustenance in this life and the next, then sacrifice for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this deen, my brothers and sisters, is not, as some people think, a deen that we sit in our homes and our mosque, and that's it. Mosque and home. That the deen's in the mosque and the home. This is a wrong belief. Islam is and always has been a nation and a civilization. It is our civilization. And there will never be a civilization that progresses or even survives unless there are those noble souls who are willing to come forth and bring out the best that they have from within themselves. Those who are willing to stand and to sacrifice their blood and their sweat and their tears for the cause that they believe in. And what greater cause is there, my brothers and sisters, than spreading the truth and justice throughout the world? What greater cause is there than spreading the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout the world? Sacrifice, my brothers and sisters, has been defined as sacrificing yourself, your wealth, your time, and your life, and everything that you have for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything that you have, and every single one of us, my brothers and sisters, every single believer, true believer, I'm not talking about those who speak with their mouths and their hearts do not say the same. The true believer, every single one of us has something that we can give, something that we can sacrifice, something that we can put in for the rise of this deen. Every single one of us has something that we can give to raise the light of Islam throughout the world. Even if you believe that what you have is small, it may be enough for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give victory. Because it is not you that gives victory. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gives victory. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن تنصر الله ينصركم ويثبت أقدامكم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, O you who believe, if you give victory to Allah's cause, He will give victory to you. And He will place your feet firm in the ground. The victory comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers and sisters. But it comes through sacrifice from people like you and I. Believers, insha'Allah, who are willing to sacrifice that in which they have. Maybe you are of those who can sacrifice his time. You are someone who learnt the Quran. Allah has blessed you with learning the Quran. Then it is upon you to sacrifice your time to teach others the Quran. Maybe you have learnt another skill that doesn't go against the rules of Islam and it is a benefit for the Ummah. Then you can use your time to teach others this skill so that it may benefit the Ummah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in an authentic hadith, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The best of you are those who learn the Quran and then teach it. And it is related from Umar bin al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, who used to say, teach your children swimming, archery, and to jump on the back of horses. Maybe you don't have any time. Maybe you're busy. Maybe you have nothing you can do in that sense. Well, then you can sacrifice some of your wealth for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is one of the greatest things that a believer can do, is to sacrifice his wealth. There are many charities, many orphanages, many places that are teaching the Quran that need money to survive, that need money to keep going. Then you could be of those who sacrifice your wealth for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And don't fear that your wealth will decrease. Rather, your wealth will increase. Just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالُهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ حَبَّةٍ أَنْبَتَتْ سبع سنابل من كل سنبلة مئة حبة إن الله يضاعف لمن يشاء إن الله واسع عليم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that the example of the one who gives in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is like that of the seed that sprouts seven sprouts. And at the end of each sprout comes 100 grains. Allah increases the wealth to whoever He wills. Allah is the all-encompassing, the all-knowing. Maybe you don't have any time and you don't have any wealth. Then what can you do to sacrifice for this deen? You can do what many of the companions did, and that is sacrifice your life. The greatest sacrifice. Sacrifice your life, your body, in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Defending Islam. Defending the borders of the believing land. Defending from the enemies that wish to bring you harm. That you can put yourself and defend and sacrifice your life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the best effort, my brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, hal adullakum ala tijaratin tanjikum min adabin alim. تؤمنون بالله ورسوله وتجاهدون في سبيل الله بأموالكم وأنفسكم ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. الله سبحانه وتعالى has said, O you who believe, shall I guide you to a transaction that will save you from a great torment? Believing in Allah and His Prophet and striving, fighting in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your wealth and yourself. This is better for you if only you knew. Subhanallah. Brothers and sisters, this is what many of the companions did in their lives. Of them were those who gave their time, like Mus'ab bin Umayyah, teaching the new Muslims their deen. Of them were those who gave their wealth, like Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, when he was asked, what did you leave for your family? His reply was, I left Allah. And Uthman bin Affan, who prepared two armies with his wealth. And there were those who sacrificed their lives for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there were those who sacrificed all three, their time and their wealth and their lives. And that was the majority of the Sahaba that sacrificed to raise the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of those, my brothers and sisters, of the Sahaba, the great companions, was a great companion by the name of Hanzala. Hanzalatun bin Amr radiallahu anhu. Hanzira radiallahu anhu was a companion from Medina, the city of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And Hanzira radiallahu anhu converted to Islam, or reverted to Islam, in the time before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam reached Medina. And Hanzira then was known to be of those who were truthful in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, truthful in his prayer, truthful in his Islam. And Hanzala radiallahu anhu one day wanted to marry a young lady by the name of Jamila bin Abdal. And Hanzala radiallahu anhu proposed to Jamila, and Jamila and her father both accepted Hanzala. So they became married. And it was around this time that the battle of Uhud was about to take place. So Hanzala radiallahu anhu went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and asked for permission from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to consume the marriage tonight. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam permitted him. And Hanzala radiallahu anhu returned to his house and spent the night with his beautiful new bride. In the morning, Hanzala radiallahu anhu woke up to the sound of the caller of prayer calling, but this time calling to jihad. Hayya ala al-jihad! Hayya ala al-jihad! Come to the jihad! Come to striving in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hanzala heard the call and woke up and quickly threw on his clothes and ran out of the door and joined the ranks of the battlefield. When the battle began, it is said that Hanzala was like a tiger seeking his prey, looking for the next one that he would take out. And he saw Abu Sufyan, the leader of the Quraysh. He went to him and he hit Abu Sufyan and held his sword about to kill Abu Sufyan, until Abu Sufyan yelled out to the Quraysh, "O people of Quraysh, I am Abu Sufyan," wanting them to come and help him. And one of them came and struck the neck of our beloved brother, our beloved Sahabi Hanzala, until Hanzala was martyred in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the battle. At the end of the battle, the Sahaba were counting the number of martyrs and getting themselves back together, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at the companions and he said in astonishment, what is it with Hanzala? What is the story with Hanzala? Wallahi, I saw the angels washing his body on silver plates between the heavens and the earth using the water from the rain clouds. The angels washing Hanzala radiallahu anhu. And the Sahaba then returned back to the city, and the brother of Jamila went and visited her and told her of the news of what had happened to Hanzala, her new husband. And she affirmed that Hanzala radiallahu anhu had raced off to join the battlefield, and he forgot, or he didn't even have time to ghusl, to wash himself from the janaba after making love to his new wife. And it was the angels that washed our beloved Hanzala in the sky with the water of the rain on silver plates. This is the sacrifice, my brothers and sisters, that the Sahaba made so that people like you and I can one day say La ilaha illallah in peace. This is the sacrifice that they made so that people like you and I may know the word La ilaha illallah. And this is the sacrifice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us to do, in which we bought paradise in exchange for it. Inshallah ta'ala, my brothers and sisters, we will take a short break and we will return just after these messages.
Lord, change our hearts. Allah is the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran in Surah Hijr, Surah number 15, ayat number 86. Al-Khalaq is the superlative of Khaliq. He is the master creator. Don't you see how we have created the camels? Allah used especially the camel. Why? Because there are so many scientific facts. This animal is unique. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inviting us. Al-Khalaq is the one who created the camel. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah has 99 names, 100 minus 1. Whoever comprehends them will have Jannah. The supreme name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Allah. Allah is the greatest name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We talked about Al-Ahad, its meaning and its implication upon us. We talked about Al-A'la, Al-Akram, Al-Awwal, Al-Akhir, Al-Zahir, Al-Batin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided everything on the face of the earth for us to do good. In order to do good, we need to first recognize the one who is the source of all goodness, and that is Al-Barr.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and welcome back my dear brothers and sisters to Living Hearts, the program that inshallah ta'ala really we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows it to be an hour in which we can grow together, an hour in which we can recharge our hearts from the trials and tribulations that have afflicted us from throughout the week. And today, brothers and sisters, we're talking about sacrifice. Sacrifice for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we learnt that we can sacrifice our time, our wealth and ourself for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to raise the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, La ilaha illallah. There is no God except for Allah. No fathers, no sons, no statues, nothing except Allah. The first and the last, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there are many ways we can actually implement this lecture or this talk today. There are many ways we can implement it into our life. Of those, especially in this day and age, is when we give our wealth for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and alhamdulillah, I know that many of you brothers and sisters are doing this already. And this is one of the best acts. In fact, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the believer's shade on the day of judgment will be his charity. And charity, my brothers and sisters, is extremely important, especially charity for orphans and those who are needy. And alhamdulillah, we managed to find a brother who has a charity organization in the country of Gambia. And Gambia, my brothers and sisters, if you don't know, is on the west of Africa. It's a very small country surrounded by Senegal. And this brother, mashallah, and other brothers with him, shuyukh, who have started their own Quran school and Quran orphanage, where the students learn Quran and they learn other areas and even many areas. So we won't wait any longer. We have our brother Muhammad Amin, Sheikh Muhammad Amin. We have him on the phone, I believe, inshallah ta'ala. Sheikh Muhammad Amin Adawi, are you there, Sheikh Muhammad?
Yes, I'm there.
Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh Muhammad.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
How are you, my dear brother?
Alhamdulillah, we thank Allah.
Alhamdulillah. Brother Muhammad, yeah. I want to, you sent me through some things about your school and I was very impressed and I wanted to do something to help you, brother, because this is a great charity, a great thing that you're doing, inshallah ta'ala. But tell us a little bit about the school. When did you start this project, brother?
This is a school we started in 2007 here in our community in Gambia. After seeing how expensive it is to teach Catholic and Hindu students to memorize Quran, it costs around $22 per month for a child to memorize Quran monthly. So we saw that there are many people here who want to teach their children to memorize Quran, but they are not able to do it. So we came up with this initiative to start a school that orphans and those children that are very poor, they will have a space to memorize Allah's Quran and will be able to learn other aspects of this deen too.
Sheikh Muhammad, when we're talking about poor, you say the students are very poor. How much are we talking about? You're talking about $1 a day or $2 a day? Or how bad is the poverty there in Gambia, my brother?
Well, we have a population of around 1.8 million where most 90% of the population lives under $1 a day. We have families who go without breakfast or lunch or even dinner. And we have families who will be able to pay for just $1, even if it has to be $1 for a child, they won't be able to pay it for. When we started this school, we were paying $50 if it is around $2 per month. But we saw that around 80% of the students cannot pay it. But when we drove them away to go for school fees, most of them didn't return. So we said, if we drive them away, we wouldn't be able to have any student. And if we didn't get any students, it means we are losing to the missionaries who are building schools and teaching Muslims to be Christians or other religions. So we endeavored to have a free education for these students. So as you can see now, they are all either orphans, so from very, very poor families, and they are missing anything for their education at the school right now. So it is a very, very bad situation that we are in. We have students whose parents can't even buy shoe for them. The shoe costs less than $1, but their parents cannot afford it for them. Nor can they buy soap even for laundry, or even to have a fee in their education.
Sheikh Muhammad,
in their education is very difficult for them right now.
Sheikh Muhammad, how many students do you have now in the center? Or you have more than one center, I believe. So how many students do you have now?
Yes, we have in all, we have 130 in our four schools who are coming from morning to afternoon. The place we are in here is the headquarters. We have 40 students here who are all on boarding set up here. They are all staying here. They sleep here. They eat here. And all their activities are in the school here. But the other schools we have in the three villages, we employ the teachers to teach them at least 4 hours a day because it's the business. Those schools too are in need of time, more time, but our administration cannot pay for those times that they have the students want. We have three students, three schools in Kuloro, Basilani, and Vida that we are operating in right now. So and we have 130 students in those schools, and we have a non-residential school too in Sukra here, where we have around 50 students, both males and females.
MashaAllah. Sheikh Muhammad, where do you find the students? You mentioned that many of them are orphans or needy. Where do you find them?
Hello?
Where do you find the students? Do they come to you or you find them out in the street, or where do you find the students?
Really, these are people, these are students that they are guardians, their parents, are teachers. So it has to take some time to 1 year before we can. Hello.
Okay, inshallah. Sheikh Muhammad, I believe that you have an initiative, a farm. I believe you have like a farm that you're trying to run. Can you tell us a little bit about the farm and its relation to the school?
Yes, yeah, we every season we try to farm at least 3 types of crops. We have peanuts, maize, couscous, other types of crops that we live on.
And Sheikh Muhammad, you mentioned, can you tell us, do you have a story, like a story you can tell us about one of the students there that that might touch our hearts? Do you have a story about any of the students there?
Yeah.
Go ahead, Sheikh, go ahead.
Sorry, I'm not getting it.
I said, Sheikh, do you have... Okay. I believe you have a story to tell us about one of the students there? A story that might touch our hearts? Do you have a story about this?
Yes, I have one student with me. It's Ibrahim Kamara. He is from Guinea-Bissau. It's a country bordering Gambia and Senegal. This student, his father died when he was around 4 years. So no one wants to take care of him because he's no one wants to take care of him because his mother was very, very poor, and the uncles too are very, very poor to take care of Ibrahim. So when his father was dying or was about to die, he told the uncles and the mother that he wants Ibrahim to memorize the Quran, but all of them cannot afford to pay for Ibrahim's education. They gave Ibrahim to one man who is a gentleman who is in this country, who sent for Ibrahim when he was very, very young. It was very difficult because sometimes he had to go without breakfast, and the guardian cannot provide for him clothing, nor can he provide for him education too. So when he contacted us, we told him the number of orphans and needy students we have is overwhelming. We cannot take care of them. But he appealed to us that Ibrahim's father wanted him to memorize the Quran. So if we cannot take him, that wasiya from his father would not come true. So we endeavored for Ibrahim to come here. And alhamdulillah, since last year, March, we registered him. Alhamdulillah, he has memorized some parts of the Quran, which inshallah, he will be reciting possibly in this program.
SubhanAllah, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make him of those who are the half of the Quran. Jazakallahu khair, akhi. The last thing, brother, I believe you have one of the students there with you to recite for us. Is that correct?
Yes, that is it.
We would love to hear from one of the students. I think you have Muhammad Al-Amin Saadi, one of the students that you have there, and we would love to hear him recite, really.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لم يكن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين منفكين حتى تأتيهم البينة. رسول من الله يتلو صحفا مطهرة فيها كتب قيمة. وما تفرق الذين أوتوا الكتاب إلا من بعد ما جاءتهم البينة وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين حنفاء ويقيموا الصلاة ويعطوا الزكاة وذلك دين القيمة. إن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين في نار جهنم خالدين فيها أولئك هم شر البرية. إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أولئك هم خير البرية. جزاؤهم عند ربهم جنات الفاتحة تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه ذلك لمن خشي ربه.
الله الله أكبر. والله Brother Muhammad Al-Amin Saadi, Jazakallahu Khair, and Sheikh Al-Amin Dabo, Jazakallahu Khair, Wallahi. You have touched my heart, and inshallah ta'ala, you have touched the hearts of the rest of the people who are watching today. Wallahi, Wallahi. Look at this, my brothers and sisters. We have children who are living on a dollar a day or less. And all they want to do is memorize the Quran. All they want to do is read the Quran. And our children are living on how much money? And all they want to do is not read the Quran. They want to do all the other things that are available in the dunya. Ya Rab. Ya Rab, make these children a good example for ourselves and for our children to follow. Wallahi, Jazakallahu Khair. My brother Muhammad Amin, Sheikh Muhammad Amin in Gambia, and wallahi, brothers and sisters, they actually are in needing of support. So inshallah, on our Facebook site this week, inshallah ta'ala, we will place their details, and anyone who wishes to give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to our brothers, you heard the evidence. You heard our young brother Muhammad Amin Saadi, wallahi, wallahi. That reading that he just read to us, wallahi, I couldn't find a mistake in it. Jazakallahu khair. Wallahi, that was beautiful, and it touched my heart, and inshallah ta'ala, it touched everyone else's heart, inshallah ta'ala. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, make this a good example for us. A good example for our children to learn Quran, and also to remember the ni'mah that we have. Think about the ni'mah that we have. Some of us have lots of money, and yet, we never stepped a foot inside a Quran school. And here we have young children who have no money, and all they want to do is go to the Quran school, but maybe they cannot. Wallahi, if you have an opportunity to give for these people, then give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers and sisters. Inshallah ta'ala, we will continue here. We'll go to the Facebook, inshallah ta'ala. Before we go to the Facebook, we will announce that we're going to open the telephone lines now, inshallah ta'ala. And we ask you to call in. Maybe you have a comment. Maybe you have some advice. Maybe you have a question. Whatever it is, call the telephone number that's on your screen now. And inshallah ta'ala, my brothers and sisters, we will be happy to hear from you. In fact, we want to hear from anything that you have to say about today's episode, about sacrifice for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe you have a question, maybe you want to give us some advice, whatever it is, call us in and talk to us, inshallah ta'ala, and maybe Allah will give you reward, and inshallah give us reward if we implement it. Now, before we go any further, we had the Facebook again this week, and once again, my brothers and sisters, if you haven't joined the Facebook, I urge you to join. Inshallah, after today's episode, we'll also put some other videos of the Quran school in Gambia there. We'll put them on our Facebook site, inshallah ta'ala. And you can see the young shabab, the youth, in action, learning Quran, reading Quran, and also working in the farm. This was a great initiative that the brother is trying to do, and that is to have a self-sustainable system. So they have a farm in which they can sell food and sell the fruits to enable to run the Quran school. And anyone who knows anything about Gambia will know that Gambia is a great place for growing fruits. And we go quickly to the Facebook. We have the question was, what are some personal sacrifices we can make for Allah and His religion? Share us your thoughts. We have Asim Muhammad Ibrahim. First we have Ihab Baghdadi. He has said, May peace and blessings be upon you too. We'll give up the music and the haram songs for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can stop watching the women on the television, but these are only a couple of examples. Jazakallahu khair, Ihab, very good advice. Let's put it into action. Salam Shaykh, in my opinion, we shouldn't call it sacrifice because it's a duty. Allah gave us everything and blessed us in His religion. Let us worship Him no matter what we give away for Allah and our religion. Ahmed, Danjuma, do everything because of Allah. We have Samia. Samia, she has said, we cannot call obligatory duties as sacrifice, like giving up harams cannot be a sacrifice. We can sacrifice our sleep and wake up for tahajjud in the middle of the night. Jazakallah khair, sister. Also Amy Sanyang and Fatima Shihu and other people commented. And inshallah ta'ala, my dear brothers and sisters, hook up to the Facebook inshallah and read the rest of the comments. There's some very good advice there that we can all learn from. We do have time for a phone call if anyone wishes to call in, inshallah ta'ala. And really, if we look at today's program, inshallah ta'ala, what we got out of it, inshallah ta'ala, was that we need to put in some sacrifices. We need to try and raise the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not enough just to sit in our houses and have this mosque house relationship, but we didn't do anything outside of that. No, we need to call people to Islam. We need to put our efforts in, our wealth, our time, whatever we can. Put it in for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you will be rewarded in the akhirah, rewarded in the afterlife. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward our dear brother Sheikh Muhammad Amin there in Gambia and the people of Gambia. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give our believing brothers in Gambia provision and to help them so that they can be of those who are living a normal life. Inshallah ta'ala, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first of all to make us of those who are sacrificing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Allah, sacrifice. Ya Allah, make us of those who sacrifice. Help us to get rid of the stinginess that are in our hearts, Ya Rabb. Help us to be of those who are in your cause, Ya Rabb, whatever it is with our wealth or ourself. Help us to be of those who are defending your deen, Ya Rabb. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us for our sins. And wherever you are, my brothers and sisters around the world, that's all we have for today. Inshallah ta'ala, I hope you benefit as I benefit. The task for this week is to sacrifice something for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And inshallah ta'ala, until next week, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Living in a lawful way, be mindful of what you say. Be sincere when you pray. Today could be your last day. Bear each other no malice. Greed and faith can coexist in the same heart. Oh Lord, only you can change our heart. We call upon you to do so, so that we may submit to you.